Bienvenue to our session on cutting-edge TensorFlow. My name is Ellie, and today with Josh, Mike, and Sofiane, we have four exciting projects for you. First, I will talk about chaos tuner. Then Josh will talk about probabilistic programming. Next, Mike will talk about TensorFlow ranking. And finally, Sofiane will show you how to use TensorFlow graphics. Let me start by telling you about chaos tuner, which is a framework we initially developed internally to bring new anti-abuse model to faster to production. Before getting started, let me ask you a question. How many of you have ever spent time optimizing your model performances? Right, I see quite a few hands raised. This is not surprising, because getting the best model performances is not easy. Getting the best model performances is hard because there are many parameters, such as the learning rate, the batch size, and the number of layers which influence the model performances. Moreover, those parameters are interdependent, which make finding the optimal combinations by hand very challenging. This is why we rely on hypertuning to automatically find the best combinations. However, so far, hypertuners have been known to be not easy to use. So if hypertuning is essential to get the optimal performances, this begs the question, can we make it easy as 1-2-3? And the answer is yes. This is why today I'm happy to introduce to you Chaos Tuner, which is a hypertuning framework made for humans. Chaos Tuner is a hypertuning framework designed to make the life of AI practitioners as easy as possible. It also helps hypertuner algorithm creators and model designers by providing them with a clean and easy to use API. For AI practitioners, which is most of us, Chaos Tuner makes moving from a base model to a hypertuned model quick and easy. Let me show you how this is done by converting a basic MNIST model to a hypertuned one. We will only have to change a few lines of code. Here's our basic MNIST model that is a TensorFlow Keras sequential API. This is something I'm sure all of you have seen already. So as you can see on the slide, all parameters are fixed. For example, our learning rate is set to 0.001. So let's transition it to a hypertunable model in three steps. First, we wrap up our model in a function. Second, we define hyperparameter ranges for the parameter we would like to optimize. Here, for example, we're going to optimize the learning rate, which is one of the most important parameters to hypertune. Finally, as a last step, we replace our fixed parameters with our hyperparameter range, and we're done. Our model is ready to be hypertuned. This is as easy. Besides offering an intuitive API, Chaos Tuner will also provide you with state-of-the-art hypertuning algorithm, tunable architectures, which are ready to go, and an automatic experiment recording, which make it easy for you to analyze, share, and reproduce your results. Originally, I started developing Chaos Tuner to quickly iterate on new models for anti-abuse purposes, including the one we developed to protect Gmail against malware and phishing. Brand detection is one of the core building blocks we need to protect your inbox against phishing email that impersonates a brand you love. This is why, today, our end-to-end example will be to show you how to build a simple and yet accurate brand logo classifier, as logo identification is one of the critical components to detect brand spoofing email. The first thing we need to do is to load our data set. For example, we have about 150 icons from various brands, including the one displayed on the slide. We also need to set a few variables, such as the batch size and the number of icons we're going to use per epoch. Next, our data set is very small, so we'll rely on data augmentation to create enough training data. This slide shows you a few examples of the augmented icon we're going to feed to the classifier as training input, the output being the brand names. We are going to save the real icon as our validation data set to make sure that our classifier did generalize well. To establish a baseline, let's first train a ResNet 101 V2, which is one of the most common and well-known model architecture. As you can see on the TensorBoard graph, our model did converge, but the accuracy on real icon is not great. We barely reached 79% accuracy. And it's also quite big, with 44 million parameters. Well, that's OK. We can use Keras Tuner to find a better model, which is smaller and more accurate. So to do that, the first thing we need to do is to create, as in the MNIST model, a model function and import tunable ResNet. Tunable ResNet is a tunable version of ResNet that we will provide with Keras Tuner as one of the architectures which are ready to tune. Next, you add a few layers on top of it and compile the model. Then, well, we initialize the tuner, and we give it 500 epochs to spend on tuning to find the best model. And we ask it to maximize the validation accuracy. Finally, we have to launch the tuning and wait for the results. So did it work? Well, yes, it did. Actually, Keras Tuner found a way better model. Our new model has now 100% accuracy and only takes 24 million parameters. So we get a faster and more accurate model thanks to hyper-tuning. Keras Tuner works with many of the tools you love, including TensorBoard, Colab, and BigQuery, and many more to come. One more thing. Hyper-tuning takes a long time, so to make monitoring convenient, we will be releasing, alongside with Keras Tuner, a optional cloud services that will allow you to monitor your tuning on the go, whether it's from your phone or from your laptop. Here is a screenshot of an early version of the mobile dashboard to give you a sense of what to expect. So the design is not final, but the UI will show you how long before your tuning complete, and as well as offer you a visual summary of the model trained so far, so you can know how your tuning is going. Thank you for attending today. We are really excited about Keras Tuner, and you can sign up today for the early access program by heading to g.co/research/KerasTunerEAP.
Yeah. I did. Yeah.
Josh is now going to talk about programmatic programming in TensorFlow.